Welcome to this Advent reflection for the third week of Advent. So far, we've been considering the words of Evelyn Underhill, encouraging us to pray more deeply and in a greater silence, to allow God the space to reveal to us beauty and the kingdom, to allow our attention to rest on Jesus as we anticipate his coming. And this week we look at the different ways we can prepare, the different ways we can adore the Christ child, placing him at the centre of our adoration. And I thought we'd look at the same painter that we did last week, Piero della Francesca, and this painting called The Nativity, which is in the National Gallery. Piero painting in Tuscany from about 1440 to 1480, a key painter in the early Renaissance. And this was one of his last works. And that's interesting, as not only does it contain many years of experience and reflection, but also he was going blind at the time. So we may assume that he wanted to put everything into this, all that he wanted to say. It's more accurately called an adoration. It shows the different ways that the people and the animals in the painting adore the Christ child. In it, we can see the background of the land around San Sepolcro, the landscape and the towers, which is where Piero was born and knew the area really well. And coming forward, we see that ramshackle hut, the shack. It's quite rare for Piero to paint something so dishevelled and on an angle when he was so geometric. Show the poverty of Christ's birth. Then in the background, an ass is braying, and the cattle look on to the Christ child. Five angels are singing on the left. And then to the right, two shepherds, one pointing maybe to the star. In front of them sits Joseph in deep reflection. Look at the lovely way that his right foot is painted. And he's sitting on the ass's saddle. And then, of course, we have Mary in a place of utter devotion, and the Christ child lying on her beautiful blue cloak. And we'll be considering each of these as the week goes on and what they have to tell us or to invite us to reflect on. Painting's in quite a bad state of repair. It's thought that it was badly treated during the 19th century. A restoration was attempted, but without the skills that we have now, so that's why. But there's still such beauty in it. The Renaissance, of course, means rebirth, a new confidence in what it is to be human. Formerly, paintings mostly commissioned by the church were religious, with a capital R, lots of gold and holiness, but nothing real, capital R. The Renaissance brought perspective and proportion, anatomy, the human body and beauty. Christ comes to earth as a human being, as our central focus. What we might term spiritual is now broadened to embrace the ordinary, the temporal and the mundane. And all of these things are to be seen within the realm of Christ. So today we will look at the central reflection, central relationship between Mary and the Christ child. It's lovely, there are so many images at Christmas that involve this gazing. This is how God looks on us, with utter attention and utter love. Not just on the outside, but on the inside too. God looks to our hearts. I wonder if you feel worthy of that attention today. Does it make you feel uncomfortable, maybe? So we pray this week that we may receive that attention from God and cherish it, just as Mary did. Maybe it warms you to feel God's gaze. Bask in it and thank God for it. God, you gaze on me with such love and all the affection of heaven. Help me to receive all you want for me, that I may bear that light and love and view your creation with the same. Amen.